Echo Cider is my business that I have. It's a cider business. So we make a variety of ciders or alcoholic beverages, little less than 7% alcohol with different flavors that we are primarily distributing in Northern California. So ultimately years ago, I wanted to do sake because sake is really, really popular.
I like sake.
Yeah. So I wanted to do that in a flavor. And my mind was like, well, I want to do a flavor sake. Well, in the United States, it's really difficult to get a sake license because you have to have a brewer's license and a wine license, and it's really difficult to get. And as I was progressing and transitioning, I had someone tell me, hey, why don't you try hard cider? I was never really into hard cider. I did drink it once in a while, but never really. And I had some, and most of the cider that I had was very sweet. And I wanted to provide a cider that wasn't sweet, that was smooth, wasn't too bitter, wasn't too sweet, but had a really good alcohol content. So I came up with the concept of going from Psycho Sake to Psycho Cider, and then coming up with different flavors no one else has. And that was part of the transition. Like, when people drink it, some folks are like, oh, I don't really like sweet. Well, why don't you try it? And when they try it, it's low sugar because we're using the fruit to it. We're not using any additives or sugars that's not directly from the fruit. So fruit enhances the sugar. It's a smooth taste. And it was about, hey, how do I get into restaurants? It was the same concept of distribution. How do I get into bars and restaurants? What does that look like? Building relationships, offering discounts, paying for advertising in retail stores as we transition into cans. Like, the same concept that I did when I was at No Limit and Me and Mine Entertainment is the same concept that I'm using for Psycho Cider, is getting into in front of as many people as possible, throwing good events, and making sure that people feel good about the product and they enjoy the product. And then the concept, the marketing concept of the people that are in the ads that I put together and that we work with different folks that are excited about it. And once we've done that, we've kind of created this excitement. We did lose a little bit of momentum with COVID. I wouldn't say a lot of momentum with COVID, but transitioning from the kegs we were doing on premise to moving into cans has kind of made us relevant again. You talked about adjusting with digital. Well, we had to adjust with COVID. By going into cans, people are going to buy alcohol some way, somehow. Why not they get it from us and we provide that to them into a retail environment, whether it's a grocery outlet or whether it's a liquor store like a Perry's Liquor or whether it's a restaurant. They are able to get, buy 4-packs, 6-packs of Psycho Cider and enjoy those things. So that whole dynamic has been exciting to me. And I've been telling everyone, I'm like, this is what I felt like when I first went to No Limit or I first started Me and Mine Entertainment. I had all this excitement and energy around putting this project together, and it's starting to just really start to grow and people are starting to know about it. I think the other thing that's exciting about it, with the internet, right, with Instagram and TikTok and Facebook and all of these things, more people are reaching out all over California and even all over the world are saying, man, I'm interested in this. And even if people can't purchase the product now because it's really only based out of California, Northern California, more and more people are buying the shirts and the hats and the doggy jackets and all those things that we have that are available for folks. People are purchasing that. And I'm getting people who are pop-up pictures all over the country. Says, man, when are you going to get it out here? So that's creating that buzz prior to us even having our license in other states and being able to move into those other states. And eventually we will get there. So that's one aspect of what we're doing with Psycho Cider. The other project that I have, I'm doing with one of my former students who's now my business partner. His name is Josh Hammer. We started Costin and Hammer Network, which is a network that we're doing with YouTube to promote different shows. Some of it's educational, some of it's comedy, some of it's about sports. And we're raising money for the Special Olympics here in California. So we're focused on the Special Olympics. Before we did the Make-A-Wish Foundation and we were able to grant a wish, now we're focused on the Special Olympics because it's important to Josh and myself, Hammer and I, that we give back to the community. And those are really the two projects that I'm really focused on right now, because that's a lot. And then
you're watching Bout That TV, your one-stop shop for the hottest urban edutainment from the UK to the US. Be sure to like and subscribe to the channel, and also join the membership for exclusive content. Yeah, so once again, be sure to tap in with the real, drop your comments, let us know your thoughts, and do check us out on our official website, boutthatonline.com. Peace.